Hello friends, you welcome to my complete Java course. In today video lecture, we are going to learn first object oriented programming concept, which is encapsulation. So let's start. Encapsulation in Java. What is the encapsulation? Encapsulation is wrapping up of data and function under a single unit. We can achieve this OOPS feature by declaring all the variables in the class as primitive and a method which will set and get the value of variables as public. Okay. So basically in the encapsulation we have a class. This class we capsule all the methods and variables. So we convert our class in the form of encapsulation. In form of encapsulation means variables and method in a single unit. We are binding the methods and variable in single unit. In which form? In which form? Listen carefully. In which form? We define a variable's name with private and getter and setter method as a public. What is the getter setter? Getter method is used for getting the variable's value and setter method is used for setting the variable's value. Example of encapsulation in Java. Like if we talk about the encapsulation, so encapsulation can be advanced form of a class. Advanced form of class. Why I'm calling the advanced form of class? Because in the class we define a variable name, method and constructor. Okay, but here we are defining a class, but for the defining a variable we are using private variables. We are not defining a public variable. Why? Basically the encapsulation says hiding the data. Hiding the data. We are hiding the data. We can hide the data only by using a private access modifier. Hiding means we are hiding from the outside of the pack, outside of the class. If we know that if we define any property as a private, we can access this property only in this class. Suppose if I want to assign some value to this property, then I can assign the values in this property only in this class. Apart from this class, if I want to initialize the value of name or assign the value to the variable of this class, then I cannot do because I have defined the property as private. Okay, so we cannot access the value directly. So how we can access this? We define a public method, two method. For one property we define two method, which is one is getter, get name, and it is returning name, and for the setting a name, set name, passing the name and assigning the name value. In the same way we are defining setter and getter for the age. So for every property we define a two method, setter method and getter method. Set is called a setter, get is called the getter. So we can call these properties or we can assign the value to this property apart from that class or from the other class with the help of only the public methods of that class. Public method of that class. That class means only on the student data. Student data's class method set and get. We have to use only the methods of set and get of this class only. We can set and get the value of that class. We cannot get or set the values from other class setter and getter method. and directly we cannot access this class property. So this is called the encapsulation form of the class. So for the encapsulation form of the class, you define the property as a private and define a getter and setter method for that properties. Now, benefits of encapsulation in Java. Number one, other class will not be able to access data directly because variables are private. Let's I show you bit practically on the Eclipse IDE. So let's I show you what is the problem if we define a fields as a public. Suppose here we create a teacher class with two fields, name and age, and this is the another class, student data. Now in the student data class, we create a teacher class object, and with the help of teacher class reference, we just assigning the name and value and printing them. If we run it, we will get the output like Ram and Tonto. So here it will create a problem. Which kind of the problem? Suppose you define a class and your properties can be changed by the other class directly because you have not control to hide the data. Everyone can use your data directly. Other class can be use your data directly. So how will you restrict your data from outside the class? You will define is a private. As you define a private, you are not accessible this field outside from this class. So the problem is, how will you set the values and how will you get these values outside the class? So you need to give a setter and getter method. So in the Eclipse, just right click on this class, go to the source and go to the generate getter and setter. Here you will ask, you want to create a setter and getter for which field. Click on this and OK. So you can see now there are setter and getter method for the name and setter and getter method for the age has created. Now if you want to assign the value for the name and age, okay, so now you will call the t dot set name and you will pass the name Ram, okay, and you will call the t dot set age, suppose you pass 20, and for getting the value also you will have to use set getter method of the teacher class. Now you are using the setter and getter method, you are using the public method of setter and getter method of the teacher class. You cannot use the student class method to access these fields. You have to call the setter and getter method to access and set the values to the property of the teacher class. So t dot get age, t dot get name. Okay, now you will run it, you will get the output 20 and Ram. Okay, so this is the concept of encapsulation. In the encapsulation, you need encapsulation says that don't create the public field, create only the private fields, and create the public setter and getter method. For initializing the value, use the setter method, and for getting the value, use the public getter method. So this is the concept of the encapsulation. Number 2, you can make the class read only by creating only getter methods or write only by creating only setter method. So what is the meaning of second point? If you define only the setter method in the class, you have defined the properties private and you define only the setter method. So in this way, if you define only the setter method, your class will be write only, means you can write the property or you can assign the values to the property, but you cannot be read that properties. In the same way, if you define only the getter method, so you can get the property but you cannot set the properties. Number 3, you can control your data. In setter and getter method, you can write the logic for special conditions. Number 4, it improves flexibility and reusability. So friends, thank you for watching this video lecture, and I hope you enjoy this video lecture and you understand the what is the main purpose of the encapsulation. So if I summarize once again, so the encapsulation means combining the data and method within a single unit, which is called the class. So in the class, we are defining a variables and methods, but which kind of the variables? What is the access modifiers? The access modifiers is private and method is public. And which method? Only the getters and setters method. So you can get and set the properties with the help of the public setters and getters methods. So now thank you for watching this video lecture. And watch my next video lecture for learning new things in Java.